So I'm not actually from NASA. I like space and I've visited a few spaceports, but I've never worked there. I'm just a code monkey. But I did work at CERN, which is the big particle physics lab near Geneva. And, you probably know about the Large Hadron Collider. It's 27 kilometers in circumference, actually 26.6, but who's counting? 100 meters underground, and they're accelerating particles really fast to try to find out about how the universe works and stuff. Actually the reason that CERN was founded back in 1954 was, it was after the war, of course, that they wanted to get European scientists working together and blowing up dipole magnets instead of blowing up each other. So, this is a poem about that. It kind of has two levels of meaning. It's called Grand Unification. Grand unification is the idea that at really, really, really high energies, like at the beginning of the universe kind of energies, all of the four fundamental forces of the universe behave the same. We can't get to those energies at CERN, but we can get to energies where some of them merge anyway. But it's also about the other goal of CERN, to get people working together. So this is called Grand Unification, and it's also available on my website if you want to read the words, but I don't have a video of it yet. You might think that we're just doing science with our Hadron Collider so large, but we built this electric alliance to give weight to our positive charge. Take researchers from every nation, let the humans within them collide. Find the grand unification when we see that we're on the same side. And with every race, tongue, and religion, we'll find how to give all the world mass if we'd all interact just a smidgen with the openness through which we pass. We'd find life's ups and downs become charming and strange when we face them head on. And what's more, seeking beauty and truth, we can make a big change, a small change from the purses of war. Take the light at the end of the tunnel and ensure it goes all the way around to illuminate more than the sun and enlighten with what we've found. When you have unresolved matters, understanding runs thin. You face too many forces to name. If you cut out the din and put energy in, it turns out that we're all just the same.